This video is brought to you by SucceedSchool.com. With complete lessons and resources, assessments, learning plans and schemes of work for students, parents and teachers, for revision, for catch-up, or just to get ahead in class, visit SucceedSchool.com now for your free trial lessons. SucceedSchool.com. Learn to succeed.
Hey class, I'm Mr Thornton and I'm going to help you succeed in your GCSE and IGCSE. This lesson, carboxylic acids and esters. This topic was requested by Jake Mesa and Hello World. Thanks guys. If you've got a topic you'd like me to cover, then just leave a comment below. Firstly, I'm assuming that you've already watched the last video on carboxylic acids and the alkanes and alkenes videos too. If you haven't seen them, the links are on cards up here and you really should take a look at both of them before you watch this video. An important principle in organic chemistry is that when an oxygen atom is stuck to a hydrogen atom, as we have here, it makes a molecule polar. All that means is that the hydrogen has a slight positive electrical charge and the oxygen has a slight negative electrical charge. This makes them weakly electrostatically attracted to oxygen-hydrogen pairs in other molecules because the opposite charges attract. This is known as hydrogen bonding. This is particularly important in water, which has two oxygen-hydrogen pairs per molecule, of course. This hydrogen bonding, the weak attraction of positively charged hydrogens to negatively charged oxygens, is what keeps water molecules stuck together as a liquid at room temperature when most other similarly small molecules are gases. Any molecules with an oxygen and a hydrogen, like this, tend to be soluble in water. So all of our carboxylic acids will dissolve in water with weak bonds forming between the molecules like this. Remember, alkanes and alkenes can't do this. They don't have that oxygen-hydrogen group, that OH group. So they don't mix with water. But carboxylic acids do mix with water. The neat thing about carboxylic acids is they also have this other end of the molecule, which is just like an alkane. So this end lets the molecule dissolve in water, and that end lets it dissolve in alkanes, alkenes, and other oily substances. This makes carboxylic acids work as emulsifiers. For example, we use vinegar, which contains ethanoic acid, remember, in salad dressing to help the oil-based and the water-based parts of the dressing mix with each other. As the name suggests, carboxylic acids are all acidic, but they're only fairly weak acids. Ethanoic acid is present in vinegar, and you eat that, so it can't be a very strong acid. For higher tier students, as with all weak acids, this is just because the molecules only partially ionize when they're dissolved in water. So they don't release as many hydrogen ions as an acid like hydrochloric acid. However, they will still react a bit with alkalis and bases. Here's an example of this reaction, and one you can try at home if you want. The white powder here is baking soda, which is actually the chemical sodium bicarbonate, and it's a base. I'm going to add a little vinegar containing ethanoic acid, and as you can see, we're getting signs of a reaction, with effervescence showing that a gas is being produced. Have a think for a moment about what that gas might be, and we'll see if you are correct in a minute. As with everything else in chemistry, these reactions always follow a pattern, and the same is true here. Let's say we were adding ethanoic acid to potassium carbonate. We always get a metal salt as the carbonate group switches places with the ethanoic acid, giving us potassium ethanoate. The metal is just the same, and the rest of the name of this salt is just the name of our acid combined with the suffix ate or ate. With other acids, we'd end up with methanoate, propanoate, or butanoate. Yet again, the name tells you how many carbons there are. We also get a couple of side products, and it's always the same too. Water and our gas, which you saw being formed a moment ago. We're reacting with a carbonate, so the gas is carbon dioxide. As a side note, if you ever have to state which gas is formed in science and you've got no idea at all, guess carbon dioxide, CO2, especially if there's anything containing carbon or with carbon in its name in the reactants, for example, carbonate. Carbon dioxide is far and away the most common gas you'll see produced at GCSE and IGCSE level. So if you've got no other idea, it's probably going to be a pretty safe guess. Now we know the pattern, we can swap in any carboxylic acid and any carbonate and predict the outcome. Sodium carbonate and methanoic acid just forms sodium methanoate and carbon dioxide and water. lithium carbonate and propanoic acid forms lithium propanoate and carbon dioxide and water, and so on. Now, if the acid reacts with a pure metal instead, such as butanoic acid reacting with zinc, for example, the salt formed is named in exactly the same way, zinc butanoate in this case. The only side product is hydrogen gas, the same product we get from all metal acid reactions. Finally, you need to know about the reactions of carboxylic acids with alcohols. Now we're getting the hang of these naming patterns, I'm just going to cut to the chase. Alcohols are also named by how many carbon atoms are in their chains. So we've got methanol for one carbon atom, then ethanol, propanol and butanol, for example. When they react with a carboxylic acid, they form a new molecule called an ester and a water molecule too. We generally use a catalyst such as sulfuric acid to speed this process up. Esters are fragrant compounds, often used in perfumes or some kinds of sweets. The name of the ester is based upon the name of the alcohol first, methanol, ethanol, propanol or butanol, and then the name of the carboxylic acid, methanoic, ethanoic, propanoic or butanoic acid. If we start with ethanol, the ester's name will start with ethyl. If we add ethanoic acid, the ester's full name will be ethyl ethanoate. This is the only one you need to have heard of. And look, it's got two carbons over there on the left for eth, and two on the right again for eth, hence ethyl ethanoate. This is the main ester you need to be familiar with at this level, though I'll bet that you could now name and draw a bunch more, like methyl propanoate or butyl methanoate, with the chains of carbon atoms just spreading out from the same central section each time. So as long as you know the name, you know how many carbon atoms to include on each side. That's chemistry. It sounds complicated, but once you know the code, it's actually really easy.
Lightning round!
Any organic chain molecule with a COOH group, which looks like this in a structure diagram, is a carboxylic acid. They're named for the number of carbon atoms in the chain, just like with alkanes and alkenes, and the four you'll see most commonly are methanoic acid, ethanoic acid, propanoic acid, and butanoic acid. They're all weak acids. For example, ethanoic acid is found in vinegar. If we oxidize an alcohol, for example ethanol, either by fermentation or by adding an oxidizing agent like acidified potassium manganate 7, we form the corresponding carboxylic acid. They're all soluble in oil like alkanes, but also soluble in water, thanks to the polar OH section of the molecule. They form a salt such as zinc ethanoate and hydrogen gas when we react them with a metal. Reacting with carbonates, they also form a salt plus carbon dioxide and water. Adding carboxylic acids to an alcohol with a sulfuric acid catalyst forms fragrant compounds called esters, which are just the two molecules stuck together with an excess water molecule removed. The number of alcohol carbon atoms gives us the first part of the name, and the number of carboxylic acid carbon atoms gives us the second part of the name. For example, ethanol plus propanoic acid gives ethyl propanoate. I hope that video really helped you. If it did, it'd be great if you let me know in the comments. Remember to like, subscribe, and hit the bell to get a notification the next time I upload a video. If you check the description, I've got links to my revision guides, to SnapQuiz, that's my revision website and app, and to succeedschool.com. That's my website with full lesson plans, schemes of work, and end of unit tests for both teachers and students. I've also got links in the description to my Twitter, my Instagram, my Patreon if you want to support the channel, and there's links to my other YouTube channels, Not School and Not School Plays. You can also click just here to subscribe to this channel, and you can click here to check out this related video. Good luck in your GCSEs and IGCSEs, and thanks very much for watching.